wanted to make a real nice turkey cream soup from scratch. That's what we are going to do. My name is Monica Chaveniak here with Fearless Cooking. Today we're going to make a turkey cream soup. I have some oil here and I'm going to add some butter here. We're going to make a quick white sauce. I'm showing you. Which is basically a little bit of oil, a little bit of butter, and then a little bit of flour. Now the thing about the flour is you need to cook that flour. I'm cooking this for about a couple of minutes, a little bit longer. I'm going to adding a little bit more flour, just a touch. And then I am going to add my milk. You can use regular milk, you can use cream, or you can use coconut cream, as I am doing. It gets creamier and creamier and creamier, and gets thicker and thicker, and then we'll keep adding our liquid. Here we have our great Turkish stock. Okay, we're gonna keep creaming this up because it gets thicker and thicker. I'll give it a little rest and let it get thicker now. I like to get it a little bit thinner. It doesn't need to be that thick because the soup will, if you keep it overnight and reheat it tomorrow, it will be getting even more thick. So I'm going to put a little bit more stock in here. By the way, this stock has amazing flavors. And I have some vegetables here that from the stock pot that we're going to put in. Look at this, beautiful, beautiful. And I'm also going to put a little bit of nutmeg in. You can spice it up if you like, if that's your deal. We don't want it too spicy. One more like homey. A little bit of pepper. And then we're gonna give this a little taste test. And here's our beautiful soup. Fresh carrots, fresh squash. We used everything up for the stock turkey. This is so much better than buying store-bought stocks or soup for that fact. Yeah, all we need is a little bit of that. We need a little bit of love. Going in with a little bit more love. Cream of turkey vegetable soup. Made from scratch, made from all your turkey trimmings and your vegetables. What's not to like about this dish? I hope you try it in your Fearless Kitchen.